Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss about authentication applications. In this, we will consider authentication function, and it is basically used to develop application level authentication and digital signature. In this, next we will consider Kerberos and X509. Basically, Kerberos is a private key authentication service, and X509 is a public key directory authentication service. So firstly, we will discuss about Kerberos. Kerberos basically is a third-party key distribution system which is developed as a part of project at MIT. Basically, it uses client-server architecture. So it provides centralized private key third-party authentication in a distributed network. It allows users to access the service distributed through the network. There is no need to trust all the workstations. Basically, it provides central authentication service through which the client communicate with the server. It has two versions which are in use, version 4 and version 5. So basically, as we know, it is developed as a part of project. So according to this report, these are the requirements of Kerberos. First one is secure. It should be secure. There is no eavesdropping, means third party should not listen the communication between client and server. It should be reliable. Transparent, should be transparent to all, scalable, it can be enhanced. Now, basically this is the overview of Kerberos. If the client want to communicate with the server, firstly, the request is sent to the Kerberos. Basically, Kerberos is what? Kerberos is a consist of authentication server plus database. If the client want to communicate with the server, firstly, client send request to the authentication server, right? This authentication server verify the request sent by the client with the help of database, and after the verification, ticket is sent in response back to the client. Then that ticket is again sent from client to the server, and then server respond back to the client. So basically, how client and server, how can they communicate? They can communicate with the help of authentication server, which is actually a Kerbero, which is the which consists of authentication server plus database that is used to that is used by the authentication server to verify the request of client. So in this, we will consider, this is a simply the authentication dialog. Firstly, we will use these terms. If we are using CC means client server, AS means authentication server, V's for server, IDC means identifier of user on C, means this is the identity of client, ID, identifier of V, that means this is the identity of server. PC is means password of user on C. C means client. AD means network address of C. KV is a secret encryption key which is shared between AS means authentication server and the server. TS stands for timestamp that we have sent during the communication, and this symbol is used for concatenation. Actually, these are the terms that we are now using to represent the authentication dialog. As we know, firstly, request, client send request to the authentication server. So first step is client send request to the authentication server. This request consists of ID of C, that means this is the identity of client. PC is a password of client that the authentication server has to be verified. Then ID of V, this is the ID of server, that means client want to communicate with this server. Then authentication servers send response to the client, that is known as ticket, right? And then that ticket is sent from client to the server, and this communication include ID of C means identity of client plus ticket, which is given by the authentication server. Basically, this ticket contains ID of client, that is identifier for client, PC is a password of client, ID B is identity of server. And this is protected by the encryption key. This is a secret encryption key which is shared between AS and server, that is V. This is the basic of Kerberos. Now we will discuss about V4, means version 4. In this, there is an enhancement from the previous one. In this, we will use authentication server, and the second thing is ticket granting server. So basically, as we know, it is a third party authentication scheme. In this, we have authentication server that is used to communicate, and that is in this client send request to the authentication server, and then authentication server responds back to the client. And then we will use ticket granted. granting server. That means instead of using one server, authentication server, in this we will use authentication server as well as ticket granting server, that is TGS. Now how it works, this is the overview for CAGROS 4. In this is known as CAGROS. It includes two servers. First one is authentication server and second one is ticket granting server, right? This act as a database. Now how this will how the communication done between these three. This is a client, this is a server, and this is a CAGROS. Now how client can communicate with the server with the help of these CAGROS. Now firstly, the first step is, firstly client send request to the authentication server. This is a request, the ticket granting firstly request for the ticket. That means that request is accepted by the authentication server and verified by the password with the help of this database. Then authentication server respond back with the ticket plus session key sent from server to the authentication server to the client. So basically this ticket is not for the server. Firstly this ticket is for the ticket granting server. Then that ticket is sent to the ticket granting server, that is a TGS, right? And this TGS will respond back with again the ticket which is used for the communication between client and the server, plus a session key between TGS, and a session key is shared with the ticket. Then this ticket is again sent to the server, right? And then servers verify the tickets and authenticator, and then grant access to the service. That means this provide response to the client. So basically how client can communicate with the server. Firstly, it will go to the authentication server. Then authentication server will give the ticket for the TGS, not directly of the server. It will give the ticket of TGS and then request sent to the TGS, and then TGS give the ticket of the server, right, which helps to communicate between client and server. This is the basic idea for CAGROS 4 overview. Now this is a authentication dialogue as we discuss now. Firstly, client sends request to the authentication server, right, and this request contains ID of C, means identification of client, ID of TGS, means this is a, as we know, firstly authentication server send the ticket of TGS, not directly of the server. Firstly, it sent ticket for the TGS. Now, ID of TGS and timestamp that we have to this symbol is called concatenation. These all are concatenate. This means this is a part of request. Timestamp, ID of TGS, and ID of client, right? And then authentication server, right? Request is sent to the authentication server. Then now this ticket and session key is sent back to the client. This ticket is for TGS. Always remember. Now this is a next is a AS respond back to the client, and this contains a ticket, and this ticket is EKC, that means it's encrypted by the secret key, and this contains KC and TGS, means this is a session key, right, ID of TGS, again the timestamp, lifetime, and then ticket of TGS, right. Then after that, ticket granting service exchange. In this as we know, this ticket is sent from client to TGS, right, and this request contains ID of server, ticket of TGS, and authenticator, so that there should be authentication between sender and receiver. Then next is this TGS again send response back to the client, and that response contains KCV, that means this is a session key between client and the server, ID of server, again the timestamp, and the ticket for the service. And this is server, this is the all encrypted with the help of encryption key, that is secret key EK. Again that means again there will be communication from client to the server. Again client sends this DAC ticket and authenticator, means this will authenticate the client ID, right, authenticate to the server, and then server responds back to the client. So basically how client and the server communicate with each other. Firstly, the ticket of firstly send request to the authentication server, right? And then it will send the ticket for TGC, right? That ticket is sent. With the session key. Basically, authentication server send the ticket for TGC and the session key for the client. Again, client requests to the TGC with the help of that ticket, and then TGC responds back to the client for the ticket of server, right? And then that ticket will help to send request to the server, and then server responds back to the client. This is the about authentication dialog. Now, next is Kerberos Real. So basically, in Kerberos 4, we are doing, we can, that means this client can communicate with the server in a single network, right? Now, real means used when the client want to, let's suppose this is a client, right? Let's suppose a client want to communicate the another server which are in another network. Client to the client want to communicate to the server which is in another network, right? Let's suppose at that time, this is the term is used, that is Kerberos Real M. In this environment consists of Kerberos servers, number of clients, all are registered with the server, application servers, sharing keys with the servers, and typically this is single administrator domain. If we are having multiple Real M's, then their Kerberos server must share the keys and trust. Basically, Real M is used when the client want to communicate with the server of another network, right? Let's suppose these are two networks. This is the client and this is the server. Let's suppose this client want to communicate with the remote server, which can be in any network. So now this communication is done. Let's suppose with the help of Kerberos. Firstly, client send request to the application authentication server, this is a part of Kerberos. That consists of authentication server, TGS, ticket granting server, and database. So firstly, client send request to the authentication server, right? And then authentication server responds back to the client for the ticket for TGS. Then this again, with the help of this ticket, client again send request to the TGS, and TGS again spawn back to the client with the ticket of remote TGS, right? That means this client want to communicate with a remote server. So this TGS, when this TGS respond back to the client, it will give the ticket for remote TGS, right? Not to the server, because this server is under this Kerberos, right? And then this ticket of remote TGS, now client send the request for the remote server. This client again sent request for the remote server, and this TGS again respond back to the client with the ticket of remote server, and with the help of this ticket of remote server, client can communicate with this server. That means Kerberos Real M is used when the client want to communicate with the server which is at another network. Now next is Kerberos version 4. So basically it is developed in mid-1990s. It is specified as Internet Standard RFC 1510. So basically it is the improvement over before, but it addresses some shortcomings, right? Like encryption system dependence. As you know, encryption is used in this with the help of secret key. Internet protocol dependency. Byte order means how the data is sent, ticket lifetime of the ticket, authentication forwarding for the authenticator, inter-real and authentication, again inter-real and authentication, so that the communication is done authenticated way. Now there are also technical deficiency, double encryption, PCPC encryption, session keys and password attacks. These can be shortcomings and the deficiencies of Kerberos version 5. Thank you so much.